Hello, this is Ankit Reddy. Welcome to the .NET course from educators.com, world's best online training tutorial for the leading technologies. Today, let's discuss about number system and memory units. Number system and memory units. When we type some letters or words, the computer translates them in numbers, as computers can understand only numbers. Let me tell again, when we type some letters or words or anything in a computer, the computer translates them in numbers, as computers can understand only numbers. A computer can understand positional number system where there are only a few symbols called digits, and these symbols represent different values depending on the position they occupy in the number. A value of each digit in a number can be determined. Let me tell a value of each digit in a number can be determined the digit and the position. The position of the digit in that number and the base of the number system, that is most important, the base of the number system, where base is defined as the total number of digits available in that number system. So how many number systems we have? Let us see that. The types of number systems are as follows. One is binary number system, and then octal number system, then hexadecimal number system. Remember that which is not specific to the .NET framework. It will be applied for all the languages. Whatever, it's like a computer. Number system and memory units will be applicable for all the languages which are there in the market. Let us see one by one what is that binary number system first. Binary number system. Usually, before talking about these number systems, the number system that we use in our day-to-day life is called what? Apart from these three, binary, octal number system, hexadecimal number system, we have a decimal number system in our day-to-day use. Suppose the number system that we use in our day-to-day life is the decimal number system. Decimal number system has base 10, as it uses 10 digits from 0 to 9. But before this, talking about binary number system, let us talk about decimal number system that we use in daily life, 0 to 9. In decimal number system, the successive position to the left of the decimal point represents units, tens, hundreds, thousands, and so on. What I am talking is, suppose you have a number like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is called units, tens, hundreds position, thousands position, lakhs position, 10,000 position. Then if you have other number, then again this will be a lakhs. So it will be keep on increasing by 10 times. So as a computer programmer or an IT professional, we should understand the number systems which are frequently used in the computers. So what is that binary number system? First thing we'll discuss, it will be having a base 2 and digits used are 0 and 1. This is called binary number system. Then next thing is octal number system. Which will be having a base 8. And digits used are 0 to 7. 0 to 7. The final one is hexadecimal number system. digits base is 16 for this, and the digits used are a little different, 0 to 9, as well as letters also used. Those are from A to F. So these three are number systems available in computers, whatever the language you are using. Binary number system have base 2, octal number has base 8, hexadecimal number has a base 16. So let us see some more about this binary number system. Binary number system is like, it will be used two digits, 0 and 1, also called as base 2 number system. This binary number system also called as base 2 number system. Each position in a binary number represents a power of the base 2. Just for example, is suppose a binary number example I am giving here. Somebody has given to you to convert it to decimal number system, 10101. So it will be having base 2. So what is the value for this is, we can convert this like 1 into 2 to the power of 0. Then I am calculating from right side to left side, 1 into 2 to the power of 0, before that 0 into 2 to the power of 1 will come here, then before that 1 into 2 to the power of 2, that means 2 square, it is 2 square and it is 2 to the power of 1. Here it is 2 to the power of 0. And then 1 is over, 0 is over, and 1 is over, and before that again 0 into 2 cubed. Then again, finally, 1 into 2 to the power of 4. No, yes, 4. So, commonly, these values will come like 2 to the power of into 1 is like 16. Whatever the number and multiply by 0, it will become 0. Then again, it has 1. 1 into 2 square. 2 square is 4. Again, whatever the number into multiplication of 0 is become 0. Then finally 1 to the power of 2 to the power of 0. 2 to the power of 0 will become always 1. 1 into 1, 1. Then finally it will become 16 plus 4, 20, 21. So this is the decimal number for the binary number system. So it will be same for octal number system, but what it will change is the base will be changed. Here base 2 we have used. The same way, suppose somebody had given you a number called, example, octal number. If somebody asked you to convert into decimal number by giving a sample like 1, 2, 5, 7, 0, base 8. So it will be as same as base 2, will be converting here 0 to the power of 0 into 8 to the power of 0, then will be 7 into 8 to the power of 1. Here 5 into 8 to the power of 8 square. So let me take this help again. I'll convert the same number. Instead of 2, I'll be changing to the 8 here. 8 and 8, 8, 8 cube, 8 to the power of 4. Here it is 0 initially. And then next value is 7. Change it to 7 here. Then it is 5. Change it to 5. Then 2. Then here is 1 is 1. So if we calculate this, 8 to the power of 4 is somewhere around 4096 plus 2 into 8 cubed. It will be 1026 and then 5 into 8 square. This one. It will be coming like 320. Then it will be 56. That's what 7 into 8. 8 to the power of 1 will become 8 only. 56 it will come. Then whatever the value of it, when it is multiplied by 0, the value will be 0 again. So which will be equal to 5496. Total, if you combine all these things, it will become 5496. So remember that binary number system will be having base 2, octal number system will be having base 8. In the same manner, it will be having hexadecimal also. Suppose, let us take an example for this. 19FDE. So it will be having base 16. Remember that you may get an interview question by asking you guys to convert this number to the decimal number system, human readable value. This is hexadecimal number system, which will be having base 16. Same way it will be like this, but it will be changing simple thing that whenever we use, suppose 0 to 9, it will be using numbers, right? Here we discussed hexadecimal numbers 0 to 9 and letters are A to F. A to F. Again, here we have each value of letters is A is equals to 10, B is equals to 11, C equal to 12, D is equals to 13, E is equals to 14 and F is equals to 15. This is how we will be calculating the values. Sorry. Now let us convert this to human readable decimal number system. So there are 5. So let me take this. The last one is E. E stands for 14. So 14 to the power of 0. A is 10, right? Then 19FDE. E is 14. Yeah, E is 14 here, and this is 16 to the power of 0 because this is hexadecimal, a base 16 we should use here. Then E value is 14, so I change here 14. Next value is D. D is 13. Then 13. 13 into 16 to the power of 1. Then F. F stands for 15 here. And then it will be changing to 16 because it is hexadecimal. Here also it will change to 16. The value is 9. Change it to 9. Then last value is 1. Again base is 16. So if you calculate all these numbers, it will be coming like 106462. So if somebody asks you in an interview, by giving this number, please convert into the decimal number system. This is a base 2. They will tell that this is a binary number system. Please convert into decimal number system. You should follow this. 2 to the power of 0, 2 to the power of 1. If it is hexadecimal, you should follow this. 8 to the power of 0, 8 to the power of 1. If it is hexadecimal number system, you should follow 16 to the power of 0, 16 squared, like this. So these are called number system will be used in our programming language. Being a IT professional, we should be aware of these things. Next thing we need to know, memory units. The memory unit is the amount of data that can be stored in the storage unit. How it is storing? What is that unit? That in which storage capacity is expressed in terms of bytes. So let us tell you that. Bit, the starting memory unit is bit, a binary digit is logical 0 and 1, representing that a passive or active state of a component in an electric circuit usually. So 0 is a passive, 1 is active here. After bit, we will be using nibble. Nibble is called a group of 4 bits. Group of 4 bits is called nibble. Then we have byte. A byte is a group of 8 bits. Then like this, we will be having 1 MB is again 1024 bytes. Like this, we will be having memory units in our storage units. So let me tell you that 1 KB is equals to 1024 bytes. Then 1 MB is equals to 1024 kilobytes. Then 1 GB is equals to 1024 MB. Then 1 TB is equals to 1024 GB. We have petabyte. Petabyte is 1024 TB. So TB is equals to terabyte, and TB stands for petabyte. So these are the storage units we have in our programming languages, or which is related to computer terminology. That's it. So number systems are called 3 types. One is binary number system, then octal number, then hexadecimal number system. Binary will be having base 2, and octal number will be having base 8, hexa will be having base 16. And when we come to this memory units, it will be having like this. 1 bit is binary digit is logical 0 and 1. 0 stands for passive, 1 stands for active. Nibble is group of 4 bits, and 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, and 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 bytes, till 1 terabyte equal to 1024 bytes. Hope you understand this entire thing. Thank you for watching. In the next video session, we'll be discussing about Hello World program and structure of the C# program can be explained. And thank you for watching.